Welcome to day 20 of the handstand challenge. Day one of Matt's challenge not to do this every time he starts a video. We call those in coaching a filler. So it's like you're doing something kind of like to fill the space or fill your nerves or anything else. What we've got planned today, remember last time we said we're going to do a little bit of freestanding work every single session now. So just to keep that in mind, your session is going to be fairly similar to what it was last time. We're going to change the emphasis of the skill, and we're going to change the emphasis of the buying a little bit. But most of the elements we're going to keep the same. So for your warm-up, we're going to do wrist rocks, 10 in each direction. Remember your wrist ups from last time where we're going from this 90 degree position, using your fingers to push up, pull back down. Remember, the further away from your knees they are, the harder it's going to be to use your weight. Eventually, you could do them from a push-up position, not that we need to, it's just a warm-up, but that would be kind of like the eventual progression to show that you've got the wrist strength to be doing that. Shoulder PNF, so 5 seconds push, 5 seconds relax, yeah, deep breaths in, 5 repetitions, and then straddle good mornings with plates or an object on your back. Remember, if you don't have the plate or the object, don't worry. Note whether you are getting lower. So maybe film yourself, see if you're getting lower into that position. Maybe after 20 days of doing fairly similar things, you should be finding that you're getting a little bit better at it. For your buy-in, we're going to do 3 rounds again. It's going to be 5 buddy hops. Remember, try and stack your body in a nice straight position. It's a great drill to start getting your confidence with that balance. You're then going to do 5 shoulder flexions. So you're going to get your PVC pipe shoulder width apart. You're going to push into the floor for 5 seconds, and then you're going to lift off and hold for 15 seconds. So a little bit of a change there. You're then going to go into your shoulder extension where we're flat on the floor in that L position. If I just go and grab this dowel a second. Let's revisit that for your shoulder extension. We're going to be here, flat. We're going to push into the floor for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then lift off for 15. For your shoulder flexion, we're going to place the PVC pipe behind our backs. We're going to push into the floor for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then lift off for 15. That's just one of those each round, and really try and progress the distance that you get to. After we've done your shoulder flexion and full shoulder extension, we're going to do a 20-second hollow hold. For your skill section, we're going to work on wall pullaways. So again, you're going to kick up against the wall. See if you can kind of like work away from the wall, hold away from the wall for a little bit longer. Yep, and then see if you can relax back in. If you're starting to fatigue and you're kind of having to kick off the wall, just come back down again. But try and remember, keep your body as tight as you can. Reach your legs as tall as you can. Squeeze your shoulder blades together. Squeeze your heels together. Try and make your body as tight as you can, and then pry yourself away from the wall with your fingertips. You can do anywhere between 5 to 10 sets of those. It's going to depend how long you're staying up against the wall. If you're staying up against the wall for a good minute, maybe don't do 10 rounds of it. Maybe only do 5. But if you're finding you can only stay up against the wall or you're falling back down fairly quickly, maybe go up to towards 10 sets.
Check.